it's like the bass, I guess, you know, it's like iconic. And to me, it stands out like as the same way the Tele stands out for a guitar. You know, it's like the first one you know, the first shape. It's like the only one. Probably my favorite bass that I've ever owned was, it's a Sunburst. It's like a 57, I think. And I just played and played and played that bass, and it was probably, it's in retirement now, but you know, I have so many memories of it. Because of playing P basses, I was definitely interested in having a more almost metallic or driven kind of bass sound. Like it was less, I always wanted it to be less round and less obtuse, and that was the clearly the easiest bass for me to do it with. Early on, the bass players that I was most interested in actually happened to all pretty much play P basses, and it was, you know, Duff was first, and it was interesting because I was like, I mean, he would play these rad bass lines inside guitar songs where you wouldn't expect it at all. And then it was like Mike Dirnt and Mark Hoppus, like when I got into punk rock or whatever, and it's like these guys were all playing the same or signature models of P basses. When I got the chance to have a signature bass, it meant so much to me. Like I'd always looked at these signature basses, whether it was Sting's or whether it was Mark Hoppus's, and I was like, you know, what would I do that was different, you know? And it's like, I wanted the maple neck. I wanted, you know, the jazz body. I know that one of the biggest things that I really was really interested in was that when we play live, half like, you know, in the early days, I would have to, you know, take off my knobs because I would, you know, turn down the volume or turn down the tone. So like on my basses, I just make the knobs do nothing. They're just always on. But I wanted to have really simple control where the volume is the only control there is. This is the new color combination for my signature bass, but I wanted the maple neck. I wanted to be able to include a design that's really been a staple throughout my life, this bat heart. And again, I wanted to only have one knob on the bass. And the Duncan pickups are absolutely amazing. I think that people don't really know, but I actually recorded Foley Adu with my Squire bass, not a custom one. We A-beat him, and it actually won out in sound quality. So the bass that is my signature model, the Squire version, is the one that I played on the record and is the one that I play live. The one thing I have to say about Fender as a company and the basses that they make, they've always been so supportive of me and I think of a lot of young musicians. I don't think of Fender so much as a company. I think of it as like, it's like a lifestyle, and it's, you know, it's been something that's really been big in my life and for such a long period of time. And it's kind of cool to be able to grow within the brand and to have it grow with me. Sometimes we take chances, sometimes we take